These cute, adorable axolotl NFTs are on the rise. Let's jump in and have a look at the axolittles. First up, I want to say if you like up the video, it really helps the YouTube algorithm. Also, I've put in chapters below so you can fast forward to the sections that you want to see so you can navigate the video easier. Also, this is not financial advice. I'm not a financial planner. So please do your own research before investing in the NFT space. Anyway, let's jump in and have a look at their website really quick. So the website overview, Axolittles, you can see here, the animation is cute. These are a profile picture project, but they're animated and they've just got a very cute cartoony aspect to them. They've sold out on their website, so you're gonna have to go to the secondary market to get them on OpenSea. So what is an axolittle? An axolittle is a collection of 10,000 algorithmically generated pieces of art. They have over 160 traits and they're animated into a 48 frame GIF, which then gives you that animation and that motion. And having a look at the roadmap, it looks pretty standard for what you'd expect. And they're also doing a charitable donation at the end to benefit the axolotls, which a lot of projects are kind of doing now. If they are incorporating an animal into it, they usually kind of donate to a refuge or some charity, which will help out that animal in the wild, which is good to see because it shows that the NFT space isn't just about making money, but it's also about giving back. Now, there is a 3-person team consisting of an artist, a coder, and a marketer. Now, before I go on, a big shout out has to go out to Brett Malinowski. I was checking out his videos and came across his video about the axolittles. And that's a great video that Brett put together where he references another video where he picked this up about 10 days ago. So if you click up here, you can go check out that video after you've watched this one, of course. So jumping over onto their Twitter, we can see that they've got almost 20,000 followers. Now, what I'm liking here is on their Twitter, they're not just posting up the same kind of art over and over. They're actually kind of putting up some axolotls. They're posting memes. They're kind of showing the community here and kind of teasing what they've got. It's nice to see that they're not just kind of posting the same content again, going, hey, buy our stuff. They're going headfirst into that axolotl theme, which is really cool to see. Now, jumping in over onto their OpenSea, we can see here 10,000 items, 4,000 orders with a price floor of 2.9. Now, if we click on the buy now, we can see here that you're gonna get one for about 2.9. Now, at the start of the video, I did say that they're in an uptrend, so let's jump over and have a look at the stats. Deployed 8 days ago, we can see here that the volume spiked as you would get with a drop, and then all of a sudden it kind of bottomed out. But 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 days in, and you can see that there has been 4 days of an uptrend. So you can see that there is some momentum building and that this wasn't just a pump and dump and that they're really keen on building the community and the community is aware of it and sharing it. And as the price increases, people are going to share more. So it's just going to compound over, which is good to see. And the average price range is denominated by this middle line here. You can see that the average price is slowly climbing, which is great to see. And let's jump over and have a look at the individual transactions and see who's buying these axolittles. So the notable buyers are denominated by the yellow dots here. And what you can see is there's a giant cluster here. And this was on the 16th, so yesterday. Now we're into the 17th and there's been more notable buyers. So what we're seeing here is that people that are notable within the space are actually starting to see this project, see the strength, and they're starting to ape in, which is a really good show of strength for this project. Having a look at the top holders of axolittles, we can see that the highest holder has got 286, 113, then we kind of hit the 80s and it goes down very fast into the 20s. So you've got a couple of people that are holding big, but not too huge. But it's nice to see that there is a somewhat of an even distribution of the axolittles when it comes to the top holders. So the top balances over time, apart from the very top holder, which is slightly offloading, everyone seems to be gaining more, which is nice to see. So it seems that the people that have bought in are continuing to buy in over time, which is great to see. And then this is where it gets really, really cool. If we have a look at the smart money. The smart money bought in on the 15th and it's just there, it's gaining momentum. So what we can see here is that at the start, there was no real smart money, but they're starting to see the strength in this project. Now this could be a Discord group of buyers trying to jump in and pump something up. But the nice thing to see is that it hasn't gone crazy. It's like they're dipping their toe and they're starting to kind of get into it a little bit, which is nice to see. We're not seeing a crazy huge spike. We're not seeing people ape in and buy 100 a piece and just absolutely boost that price floor up to then drop it on. They're kind of dipping their toe, kind of putting some into their portfolio to kind of hold, which is very, very nice to see. Now jumping in and having a look at the unique addresses, over time, it just keeps getting more and more distributed. So at the moment, 4,300. When it started, it was at 3,000. Now the trend is currently in an uptrend, which is nice. So it shows that the larger holders are distributing this and more people in the community are actually getting it. And it also shows that people are actually kind of finding it, discovering it, and deciding to jump in and purchase, which is a very good sign because it shows that it's not just a bunch of people trying to hold it and pump it, but you've actually got a bunch of the community and people that are discovering it, deciding to kind of invest in this project and kind of add an axolittle to their collection. Now, looking at the amount of people that are only holding one, we can see that it is a steady climb. So the fact that this chart looks very similar to the unique addresses. So my interpretation of this data is that people are buying and holding one, and that is contributing to the unique addresses because they look very, very similar, which is nice because it means that people kind of see some potential in the project and they see some upside. So they buy one, put it in their collection and kind of most likely hold it. Someone that's buying one most likely won't flip it, as opposed to someone that's going to buy 10 to try to flip one or two and then hold onto the rest for the upside and just kind of take some profit off the table with the ones that they've sold. The people that are buying one to hold one, they're usually going to be a long-term holder in my perspective. Now, if we jump down and have a look at the top diamond hands, 81, 61, 60s to about the 20s. So you can see that the diamond hands have kind of been selling down, but I don't necessarily see this as a bad thing in the short term. With the price rising, the people that jumped in and bought a lot at launch, as you would see here, they did have a drop, and as it increased, they've let some of their holdings go, which isn't bad. To try to recoup some of the costs, and that's what I can see. So even though some of the diamond hands are dropping off, the unique addresses are increasing, which means that the people that did accumulate a lot in the beginning are starting to offload this, and people in the community, the people that want to buy one, are starting to accumulate, which is nice to see. And real quick before I wrap this up, let's jump in and have a look at their Discord. So their Discord currently has 17,000 members, and it does look quite active. So all up, what do I think about Axolittles? I think Axolittles is a fun, cute project. It looks like the kind of project that might be nice to just buy and hold one of and see where it goes in the future. And if the team do kind of incorporate more into their roadmap and more into their marketing plans in the future, depending on where it goes. What I could see is that all it takes is a memeable item when it comes down to axolotls to kind of hit the mainstream, and then that's when this kind of gains some awareness, because an axolotl is a cute, fun animal when you kind of think about it in terms of memeable terms, like the real animal. And these NFTs look very cute and could be very memeable. Also, another thing that I could see down the track is that this could play very well into children's merch. It could play well into an animated series, and long term I could see some potential. But when it comes down to what I would personally do, I personally would buy one and hold one and keep it in the collection just to kind of see where it goes, because I feel like it has some potential upside, but there need to be a few things that need to line up for that to be the case. So anyway, thank you for watching the video. If you've got any NFTs that you'd like me to check out, drop a comment below and I'll jump in and do a deep dive and analysis of them. As always, like the video up because that really does help the YouTube algorithm. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. That's your boy NFT Nate out.